In this tutorial, I'm gonna start by doing a demo of the application that I'm gonna be building, and then I'm gonna step by step build that application. I'll start by creating a new project. I'm gonna call it WebSocket Project 04. It's gonna be running on Glassfish 4. And I'm gonna be reusing the code from the WebSocket Project 02. So I'll start from there and build on that. And here I'm gonna add a user's text area. It's gonna be a read-only, and I'm gonna be passing that as users and the JSON data passed in. So I'll check if that is different than null. In that case, I'm gonna clear out the user's text area and repopulate it. So I'll do a while loop and populate it with the different users. And I'm gonna add this code to handle the browser closing and triggering a WebSocket close event. Next, going to the chat room server endpoint. Let me change this guy to build JSON message data. And I need to add a function, get usernames, that is gonna give me back the usernames for the various chat room users. So I'm gonna instantiate a hash set and return it. I'm gonna iterate through all the sessions in the chat room user set, and I'm gonna be picking up the username of each and storing it in my return set, and then returning that set. And I'm also gonna have a build JSON users data function that is Can I return the different users in as JSON data? So I'm gonna use this getUsernames function and pick up an iterator from there, and then I'm gonna instantiate a JSON array builder. I'm gonna be picking it up through the create array builder static method on JSON. And then I'm gonna go through all the elements of all usernames and add them to that JSON array. And finally, I'm gonna put that JSON array in a JSON object, and I'm gonna call it users, and I'm gonna return that JSON object as a string. Next, when a browser for a certain user is closed, I need to remove that user from the list of users in the text area of the various users in the chat room. So in the handle close method here, I'm gonna pick up an iterator on the chat room users and iterate over those sessions, sending them the user's data. I'm gonna call build user's data, which is gonna give me back those users as a string, JSON string. And I'm gonna do the same thing for the onOpen event. So in the handleOpen method, next in the handle message method, gonna move this one to the top here. So if this user has just entered the chat room, so if username is null, I'm gonna now also update the user's text area. For the various users to reflect the new user that just logged in. Next, I'm gonna go ahead and test run the application. I'm gonna run it on Chrome.